Hi guys, Mike here, One Go Short Play, playing Corporation for the Sega Mega Drive. I had this on the Amiga, I bought it from a market stall in Sheffield when I was a student there for a year. Yeah, pretty lonely time. I basically played a lot of video games. I remember thinking this looked amazing, but just couldn't get into it. We're going to try today, but I very much doubt it'll happen. Very of its era, that isn't it, the graphics rendered 3D but in like really low palette. Let's just go for it and see what happens. Default character, don't want to be messing about. Okay, we're in. I think the Amiga version had mouse controls going on as well. This is all the joypad. It's an FPS basically, but a really early FPS and really slow. I'm facing the back wall, taking a while to turn around. I mean, it's really rudimentary. But I remember being a bit overly complex for me back then, and this was the bane of FPSs of this era, I guess, or anything that tried 3D in this era. It was so unconventional that people didn't really get them, and they had to be simplistic, you know. I'm shooting that because it looks like some sort of security thing. And let's face it, my little target set has gone to it, which means kill it with fire. That's not a dangerous thing, but it's a pick-upable. I don't know how to use pick-upables. I've got a feeling this goes all RPG when it comes to using pickups, and of course that's probably where they lost a lot of the kids, because anyone who's played an FPS knows that we want action. Something was shooting at me. Now I'm standing over that package and I can't seem to there we go. Yeah, this is where it goes a bit mousy, you see. There's no need for this level of complexity. I've picked it up, that's good. Okay, press the start button and we're off. I hope that pauses gameplay, because that's just slow. Really, you should just step over that and pick it up, but of course this was a different era. That's the alarms going off, so someone's seen me. There's some robots. Kill the camera. Damn it. Okay, and we hit pause. And then we go along to pick up. I think that's like juice. I think if I drink enough juice, I'm healthier for it. I think that's the message there, kids. Drink your juice. let's see. Okay, so I'm in some kind of underground car park complex. Someone's shooting at me, but I've got the reflexes of RoboCop, but probably not the energy bar. Hey, it's a good RoboCop game, actually. I think of this as a RoboCop game. OCP are under attack, and what are they bringing to their defense? An army of underground robots, of course. Think it over, creep. Yeah, just throwing a few RoboCop one-liners, and this game's awesome. Although this now feels a little bit 8-bit era, rudimentary, and I'm just on a big map shooting things as they come at me. I think the game sold itself as being beautiful and complex. The only thing complex about it really is the picking up of stuff and using of stuff, because it's so blinking hard to do. Oh, robot. And maybe actual moving about. There's no strafing. There should be no strafing in this game. We'll have no strafing here. I don't know how I'm moving quite so fast. I want you in my belly. In my little robo belly. I know I'm not a RoboCop, I know that, but I want to be okay. They never made a good RoboCop game. Well, that's not true. There are some good RoboCop games out there. Oh, look, I've got fists. Oh, that means, of course, I haven't got bullets. I've just basically unloaded my gun on a fence post. We're in trouble, boys and girls. We're in trouble. RoboCop's got no bullets left. Yeah, good RoboCop games. RoboCop 3, of course, is very reminiscent of that. I've seen a few YouTube videos of RoboCop 3 recently. It's met with a lukewarm response, I think, on YouTube, considering what an amazing game it was in its time. I'm not saying look at it through rose-tinted nostalgia glasses. I'm saying it is brilliant. It's an achievement. It was a beautiful game as well. I mean, the stylistic decisions that they made based on the limitations of the 3D were just spot on. And I know it was the same people who did what, Elite? I hated Elite. I didn't hate it, it was slow and boring to me. Wasn't what I like at all. Who's shooting punch it from over here. See how we had bullets now. I'm getting killed. Let's just get out of here. See how far we can walk before someone takes Robocop down. Oh, I think I know who's going to be taking me down. Ah, for the Horde or something like that. Die. I killed one. And you, and your mates. And your mates, come on. Taking you down with me, robot. Taking you down with me. Ah! Oh. This is always weird as well. So I've just been killed by like a docile looking at 209 unit. And now I'm being killed by some kind of big green monster. It didn't really tie together for me there. Yeah, there's a lot of kind of what? Hey? Who's he? What's that about? Big Green Monster Guy was on the cover. Big Green Monster Guy's on the game over. He's not in the game at all. Let's face it, I never saw any more than that of this game. I'm sure there was loads more. But it just didn't pique me interest enough to stick with it. Great music, great atmosphere, great use of the 3D at the time. If they just made the pickup stuff a bit more simplistic and they just made it, I don't know, give me a bit more ammo, just make it a bit more action-y, it would have been good. Made a good Robocop game. Robocop on the Spectrum was good. Robocop in the arcade was decent. Robocop on the Amiga was a bit poo. Robocop vs. Terminator, that's good, on the Mega Drive. The Robocop Titus game was disappointing, especially on the PS2 and the Xbox. I don't know why we're talking about this. We should really talk about this on a Robocop video, but my chances of getting to Robocop the way I do things at the moment are pretty low. We'll see. So yeah, I just have a little Robocop fix there. I feel better. Right, that's me done. Corporation Sega Mega Drive, thanks for watching.